This video is going to show the records for restoring a full arch case using OptiSplint. Now, this is a restorative case, not a surgical case. So let's go through the records. These are kind of obvious, but they're upper and lower scans of the complete arch. And this case is a lower hybrid and just upper natural teeth. So the lower is what we're going to replace. So the doctor scanned the teeth and just scanned the tissue part of the prosthesis on the lower. So basically we just need to be able to orient other files into this bite. So that's the first scan the doctor took. Then the prosthesis was removed and doctor performed a wash impression. Okay, now we have the tissue. And this will be brought into the scans that we just showed using the tooth points. Okay, and now we have the lower in occlusion. And you'll notice on the intaglio that the doctor used the OptiSplint scan bodies. Okay, these are the little plastic gray scan bodies that come in an OptiSplint kit. They simply plug into a Nobel compatible coping. And this gives us the reference for the implant position. It's not a metal to metal exact reference, so it's not like a traditional scan body, but this allows us to put the prosthesis in the right place according to a tissue scan, if a tissue scan is provided. Because when you do a wash impression, you really don't need a tissue scan, it's optional. All right, then the doctor took the OptiSplint out of the mouth, right? Did the diluting process, did a really nice job here. Okay, and then scanned this outside of the mouth with the iTero scanner. And you'll see that, you know, there's some areas here that are missed, right? You really want to get the full scan body, but if most of it is captured like here, you know, like here, you know, a lot of it, that'll work, but you really like to capture as much of that as possible. We don't need the area around it, you know, the table, the hand, whatever this thing is sitting on. We don't need the whole thing, but just scan as much as you can possibly. And then you'll notice here, this is another key to the OptiSplint. You want to target the acrylic or stellar or composite material just underneath the OptiSplint in either blobs or a contiguous motion like this where it's all connected. But you don't need to load up the entire honeycomb frame here. We just need it looted to each one of the OptiSplints. So this is a nice scan. That's just about exactly what they should look like, and you really could get a little bit more here and there, but this will work. And based on these records, we will design a prosthesis and send a file to print.